I gotta ask you. So Michigan is 14-3. You guys are 16-4.
Yes,
head
sir.
To head, you guys stomp them.
Yes, sir.
What comes to your mind when you hear that Michigan is the number one seed in the Big Ten champion this year?
Being a number one seed, you know, I really don't have a problem with that. I guess maybe if you look at win percentage, but I think if you look at the overall, you know, the fact that we played 20 games, that's where my problem is. I just feel like we should be, you know, co-Big Ten champions because we played the whole 20-game schedule. You know, some people may say, okay, their last three games, I believe it would have been against the 11th, 12th, and 13th team in a conference, but we lost to Maryland at home. You know, it's the Big Ten. Any given night, anyone can lose, so you can't just mark on your schedule, oh, these are guaranteed wins. So the fact that we played 20 games and we won 16 games, I mean, I think that's definitely, you know, should make us co-champions the very least if they only won 14, I only lost three. So we lost three.
But they went on percentage. They went on winning percentage, yeah, which they gave them the edge there. It's at Chicago. It's at Chicago.
Yeah, it's at Chicago. Was Farragut.
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt. All right. So you guys enter the Big Ten tournament here as the number two seed. You're already kind of, I think you're locked in as a number one seed for the NCAA tournament. What is at stake here, Io? Like, what motivates you this week in Indy before the NCAA tournament?
I mean, we want to get a for certain, you know, for certain championship, a for certain ring. That's our goal. That's our motto to come. That was our goal, to win a Big Ten championship. And we have a great opportunity in front of us. So, you know, that's what we're looking forward to. That's what motivates us each and every day, to go out there and try to win a Big Ten championship and hang a banner.
Is part of that that you didn't, that Michigan got the number one seed and they're kind of, you know, known now as the Big Ten regular season champs? Does that must motivate you right now, right?
Definitely. I mean, it gives us a lot of more motivation. You know, we feel like, you know, no one wants us to win. You know, we feel like we are all that we have. So it's no better way to go show it than to go win a Big Ten tournament title and then just, you know, prove everyone wrong and then hopefully, you know, get ready for the NCAA tournament, try to make a deep run there.
Now, what's this year been like? You know, it's not been normal. You guys get tested for COVID every morning. If you win a big game, you can't go out. There's no going to the bar, a party, or the frats, or whatever. Has it been fun? Like, or has it been? I know the basketball is fun, but what's it been like for just everybody? I think, or nobody actually has any idea of what you guys have really been through this year.
I mean, that's a great question. I feel like in order to maximize, you know, the funness outside of the basketball court, you have to have a tight-knit family. And I think that was something that we talked about when we first, you know, all came back, when our motto is all in. You know, we're all in for each other. We're all in for winning and everything. So when we had that conversation, we said, we're all we have, you know. No one has their girlfriend. No one has their mom, their dads, nothing. We all we have for the next 4 to 5 months. So we have to make it. What we make is going to be all our memories. So we just got closer. You know, we started, we all live like in the same building. So we had played poker together. We had played spades. We had watched the fights together. You know, we just doing everything as a tight-knit family to try to make up for, you know, the lack of, like you said, you know, going out or being able to see your family or friends.
So Illinois struggled before you got there the last few years. You guys weren't great your freshman year. Then last year, you're pretty good. I was out there right before the end of the year, and you guys were on track to have a good year. But, like, what does it feel like, Io, to be able to kind of put this program back on the map before you leave? Like, you know, the impact that you've had and some of your teammates have had to get this program now to where it's credible again. What's that feel like?
It feels great. You know, I was just thinking about it the other day after we came back from Columbus. Like, it's an unbelievable feeling. You know, I definitely want more. That's what motivates me to try to come out here and compete as hard as I can these next 3 days and, you know, this next month, because I feel like this Illinois program has came a long way. You know, from, like, I remember watching it, watching on BTN, like the TV was scratchy, the uniforms were super big, you know, they didn't have no good gear. And, you know, now
basically when I played is what you're saying. When the gear was
so seeing like how far we came and me being a big part of that transformation, you know, it motivates me to try to go win more so we can keep getting good recruits in and hopefully turn us into a great pipeline.
When you look at going to the next level, I feel like most players, they look at the league and they say, you know, this guy plays like me or this guy has had success. I want to model my game kind of after what he does. Do you look at anybody like that in the NBA right now?
I watch a lot of different people. I study a lot of different people, playmaking abilities. Like one, I like Shea, you know, his size, his wingspan, you know, the way he gets in pick and roll. I watched him a lot over the summer. So definitely when teams like try to hard hedge or anything like that, I like to see how he handles it because he has the same, you know, size as me. And I watch guys like him, like kind of like more big guards and pick and rolls, like Bradley Beal also. He's about 6'3", but I like the way he comes to pick and roll, and like when he gets to his jump shot, his mid-range jump shot is deadly. So I just like more likely I like looking at different guards and different areas of how they dissect the game to try to go out there and incorporate it in my game.